want to say it was Beauty and the Beast or The Lion King. It was a Disney movie when I was really, really little.
Probably like Little Mermaid. Lion King, Little Mermaid, one of those.
The Lion King.
The Lion King. I mean, I was like 3, but I remember it.
I didn't go to very many movies, but the first one that I remember on VHS was The Lion King. VHS kids, it was a thing.
Maybe like The Lion King, I think The Lion King. It was a couple months ago, it was Jon Favreau's. I got a sneak preview, no.
It wasn't the first film, but I remember my mother taking me to see, I think it was the Easter show, it was Bye Bye Birdie. I think that's 1963.
Piratas del Caribe. Fue la primera que vi en una pantalla grande.
It wasn't a movie theater, it was a drive-in theater, actually, a drive-in cinema. And it was this movie with Kyle MacLachlan called Hidden. Like this alien comes out of somebody's body.
Maybe Suspiria? Yeah. And at the drive-in. Yeah, I know, damn. I did not want to see the most recent version because the first one is still with me to this day.
It was called Dragon Slayer. I don't know if you remember this, it was the 80s. I'm aging myself, but it was probably early 80s, late 70s.
Oh my God, that's a long time ago. But I think it was Spartacus.
Maybe like Toy Story? I don't know, that was a long time ago. I feel ancient now that you've asked me that.
One of the Lord of the Rings movies, but I can't remember which. I want to say Return of the King, but that makes me feel really young.
I think it was Fantasia, not the original run.
One of the first might have been Dead Poets Society. A lot of rentals before that.
That's such a difficult question. Because obviously I started watching films on TV before going to the theaters because I grew up during the war in Lebanon. So when you're, you know, obviously there were no cinemas and we couldn't go to the cinema to watch a film. So I remember watching a lot of films at home on, you know, VHS tape. Films like Grease, films like Annie, Ferris Bueller's Day Off.
Do you know what I really remember? Was seeing Jurassic Park in the movie theater because I was so terrified, and I'm sure I was a bit too young to go and see it, but my older sister made me come with her.
But it was amazing. It was so transformative for me. It was a big event to go to a movie when I was growing up. We didn't go that often, and so when I got to go, it was always a big event.
I was struck that this thing was so big, and you could see this amazing story there. It was so big, and there was candy. It was awesome. And I loved movies ever since, yeah.
I felt like I'd entered into another world and was suddenly so hungry for more of that. But magic is the only word that I can describe, and it's something that I still experience, seeing movies, in theaters especially. It's larger than life, it takes you somewhere else. I love movies.
Aliens by James Cameron was the second film I saw. It was like a double bill at the drive-in, so very strange stuff to see. But it gave me nightmares, so I definitely remember it.
And here's the thing, the reason why that's significant. It opens with Anne Margaret singing the theme song, Bye Bye Birdie. And it wasn't too many years later I realized, my back of my head, begin to do the right thing with Rosie Perez singing, dancing. That came from Bye Bye Birdie. And I wasn't even thinking about being a filmmaker when I was 7, but it made an impact, and that's where it came from. And I got to tell Anne Margaret that too, over the phone.
It allowed me, you know, to escape the reality and the boredom of my own life, being at home, spending so much time at home, couldn't go outside because of the war, and spending time behind sand bags. And I think these films allowed me to really escape my own reality. And actually, they maybe it was the reason why I decided to make films in my life. I wanted to create those stories that allow me to escape my own reality and my own routine in a way, and my own personality.